yours. That's the way I like it, and I'll never get bored. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
All that glitters is gold.
Only shooting stars break the mold.
Christina, I'm one of the directors here. Thank you for coming to our production, the Woodward production of Shrek the Musical. We are going to be starting shortly. I just wanted to make some pre-show announcements that did not make your playbill today. So for the role of Dragon and young Fiona, that will be played by Akira Cho. Let's give them a round of applause. And the role of Gingy will be played by Madison Cannon. It has been an up and down week. The students have really pulled through, so cheer very loud. They put a lot of hard effort, and here we go. Enjoy.
Lived with his parents in a bog by a tree. It was a pretty nasty place, but he was happy because ogres like nasty. On his 7th birthday, him and the little ogre's parents sat him down to talk, as of all ogre parents have had for hundreds of years before. Are used to that, the hardships, the indignities, the endless stream of misery.
Hello, sorry I'm late. Welcome to Fiona the Musical. Yay, let's talk about me. Once upon a time, there was a little princess named Fiona who lived in a kingdom far, far away. One fateful day, her parents told her it was time for her to be locked away in a desolate tower guarded by a fire-breathing dragon, as many princesses had for hundreds of years before.
Mama packed a dolly for your trip.
Your papa packed your books and bubblegum.
Darling, don't be sad, the tower's not so bad. Just keep waiting,
and someday your prince will come.
Isn't it the saddest thing you've ever seen? A poor little princess, hidden away from the world, high in the tower, left awaiting her one true love.
Oh, sorry about that technical hitch. Whew. And so little Holger went on his way. Cue the happy villagers. My cue. Off you go, wee laddie. And so the little ogre found a perfectly rancid swamp away from civilization. And whenever a mob came to burn him at the stakes, he knew exactly what to do. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I'm happy why I'm all alone. I got all I need, so read the stinking sign. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I party on my own anyway. Doing what I can with the one-man conga line. Yeah, your big, bright, beautiful world. It's all teddy bears and unicorns. Take your fluffy fun and shove it where the sun don't shine. I prefer a life like this. It's not that complicated. Sure, I fated to be lonely and I'm destined to be hated. If you read the books, they say it's why I was created. But I don't care. Cause being liked is grossly overrated. Who needs a big, bright, beautiful world? I got my own little patch of the world. It's not a big, bright, beautiful world, but it's mine alone. It's mine, and it's mine.
Don't mind the mud, you'll get used to it.
This place is a dump!
Not fit for a king.
Hello? We are standing right here!
Alright, when I call your name, step forward. Pinocchio the puppet.
No, oh, I'm not a puppet! I'm a real boy!
Did you read the Lord Farquaad's decree?
Yeah, we read it. All monster creatures have been banished from the kingdom of Duloc. All perfects and freaks will be sentenced to a resettlement facility.
Don't mind the mud, you'll get used to it.
This place is dumb. Being feral talkers sucks. Be live! is disappointing. Woo is what I know. How to bind my nose, that's just how it goes. Poor, poor Pinocchio. Story of my life, always doomed to fail. Cheated by a fox, swallowed by a whale. That's the story of my life, oh yeah. That's the story of my life.
I remember it.
Oh, you can't remember your own creed, eh?
They blew our windows down.
Big battle.
Was he the jackpot?
They killed my hat.
So the big baba.
They labeled me a fat man because I wore a granny's dress.
Story of my life. Booted from the ball. The party's off the hook. That's the story of my life. That's the story of my life. I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending. I always dreamed I'd get an ever after. If this is it, it blows, it blows, it blows. Story of my life. Always up a car, always in the woods, always getting lost, always on the road, always up a creek, always kicked around and treated like a freak. That's the story of my life, yes sir. That's the story of my life, oh hey. That's the story of my life.
Shut up and follow me. Follow my leader. Man, this place is really looks like crappy. Yeah. It smells like it.
What up, girl? This is a children's show.
What are you doing in my swamp?
Oh, God! We were forced to come here!
Forced? By who?
Lord Farquaad.
Oh, well. Not my problem. Now you all need to turn around and go back to where you came from.
Can't go back. We can't go back.
Farquaad, the devil's in the rubbles.
Guys, bad news.
Wait, maybe you could talk to him.
Me? You don't even know me. But doesn't even matter. What exactly are you all doing here?
Well, we already been over that. We got kicked out of our homes.
Oi, that
dude. We got kicked out of Dula.
Right. Jesus.
No, it's not our fault someone is not here.
This is my swamp.
Well, if it's your swamp, then do something about it, huh?
Did you do something, please?
Well, I can't do anything because I'm an ogre, which means I stay on my swamp and avoid large crowds. Unless you haven't read the stories?
Well, you mean the story that say I'm the big bad wolf.
And the ones that say I'm a wicked witch.
Or the ones that say I'm a wooden boy. What? No, I'm not. I have a glandular condition.
We don't need your medical message.
Look, Carol, let me spell it out for you. We don't want to scare you more than you do, but you're the one tough enough to stand up to not that no good flimflammer Farquaad.
Tough enough? You don't even know me.
Can't you help us out with an ever after?
Can't you see that you're our only home? You're our only home. You're our only home. You're our only home.
Great, look what you did. You only hit me here at least 5 minutes or you're breaking my stuff.
Now, listen. Attention all fairy tale things. Your welcome has officially worn out. I'm going to talk to this Lord Farquaad guy and get you all off my lands and back from where you came from.
Yeah! Time to say goodbye, time to say farewell, time for you to fly, it's bitter as well. Cops are going to cry, time to say goodbye, time to say baboons, ogre on the loose. Time to say
can't be right. I'm all turned around. I took a right at the candy house. Took past that old woman in a shoe and took a left at Cinderella's castle. This can't be right. Swamp, yes. Oh, Duloc. Good.
Hey, how you doing?
I hear voices over here.
Oh, help it on yet, would you?
Ew, it's hideous.
That's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
A talking donkey, a freak of nature, as a you unsavory beast.
Whoa, now, you're going the right way for a smack bottom, you are.
Step aside, let us at him. Oh.
Why? What did he do?
I don't want to die. I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
Under the order of Lord Falcon, I'm authorized to put you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? This is the part where you run away.
Ah!
And don't come back! Lord Jesus.
Can I just say that was incredible? Man, he was tripping over himself to get away from you. I like that.
That's nice. Now how about you go celebrate your narrow escape with your own friends?
But I don't have any friends.
No, that's a shocker.
Say, you lost something?
No, I'm just trying to find the nearest route to Duloc.
Duloc? I know Duloc. You gotta let me show you the way because I am like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own, thanks.
But no one's finding their own. Not when they look like we do. Hey, didn't you hear what he said? This place is going to Stepford. We gotta join forces, otherwise they're gonna lock me in a dungeon, and I cannot go back there. I don't know if I mentioned this, but I did 6 years in solitary just for impersonating Pinata. Whoa. Can I just say that was scary? And if you don't mind me saying this, if that don't do the job, your breath certainly might.
Look! Little donkey! Take a look at me! What am I?
Yeah, okay. Really green?
What? No! I'm an ogre! You know, grab your torch and pitchforks! Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really, really.
Oh.
Man, I like you. What's your name?
Shrek.
Shrek. Well, you know what I like about you, Shrek? You got the whole I don't care what anyone thinks of me attitude. I like that, Shrek. I respect that. You're all right, man.
That's good. Goodbye.
Hey, 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 you got me to go with you. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Well, maybe you do. But that's why we gotta stick together.
Donkey!
Don't speak. Don't speak, don't speak. Just hear me out. I might surprise you. I'll be a friend when others despise you. Don't roll your eyes. Stop with the moping. You need a pal. My calendar's open. I'll treat you soon when you feel congested. I'll bail you out when you get arrested. I'll send you back when it gets hairy, and I'll be there for you. When when you need me. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. You need me. And I'll be there for you. If you kill a man, I'll hide the body. What do you say? You're not responding. I think we're bonding. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. You need me. You and me, we belong together. Like butter and crisp. Like you was a bit like yin and yang, strum and drag. Like ang and tang attached at the hip, but not an old lady hip that might break. I'm gonna be on you like a fat kid on cake. Like Cupid and Psyche, like Top Rocks and Mikey. We'll sit together like that dog was up on the fuzzy side, you're the spiky. Like little kid, those funny things that about, you know, feeding, like donuts and oh, geez. What goes with donuts? Donuts, donuts and diabetes, you need. Get him, get him! I need you, I need you, I need you, I need you. I need you, 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 I need you. I need you, 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 I need you. Don't let me go.
Because I am lost, you can come.
Woohoo! Yeah! All right!
One condition. Keep the jabbering to a minimum.
No jabbering, man. You will not regret this.
Too late.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Trek and Donkey, two Star Wars friends off on Whirlwind Big City Adventure.
My perfect kingdom.
It's not a kingdom because you're not king.
Oh, but I will be. Just as soon as I find a princess to marry. And I hear you know of one. Tell me where she is.
Eat me!
No! I've tried to be fair to you creatures, but my patience has reached its end.
Okay, well maybe I heard tell of the princess.
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man.
Yes, I know the Muffin Man, who lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
I heard it from the Muffin Man.
Can I go now?
You haven't told me where she is!
I can't!
Do it!
I won't!
Do it or I'll...
No! Not the buttons! Not my gumdrop buttons!
Then tell me where she is!
Okay, I'll tell you. She's a day walk from here in a dragon guarded castle surrounded by hot boiling lava.
Oh, that sounds dangerous.
the tallest tower, you'll find a very red-headed princess named Princess Fiona.
Ooh, Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect. Except for that dragon and lava thing. I might have to find someone else to go.
Big surprise.
I shall make Fiona my queen. And Duloc will finally have the perfect king. Captain, round up your men. Summon the citizens. And bring that cookie to the swamp.
Swamp? Is that the things I get?
Thelonious, tell the royal coiffeur I need to get my hair pressed. We're going to get a queen!
So, the rules are very simple. If you see a horse-drawn carriage along the road, punch buggy!
Ow!
Fun, right?
No! What kind of same game is that?
Haven't you been on a road trip before?
No.
Well, that's really sad because, punch buggy!
Ow!
I got your wagon full of hay over there.
Donkey, if you do that one more time.
See, that's another reason you should be happy you met me. Who else is going to fill you in on all the fun stuff you missed out on in the world? You may not have realized it, but you have one lucky ogre to have met with a donkey like me.
Punch buggy! Ow!
Ow!
Mutton cut at 3 o'clock.
Mother, how would that hurt?
You know what? That was pretty fun. Shall we play again?
No. Maybe we should move into a spa or I went on a picnic. Someone won't put me in a body cast.
Ducky, look! Lord Farquaad's castle.
Didn't I tell you I'd find it?
It's a bit much, don't you think? I think you might be compensating for something. Oh, forget it.
That's new, Mark.
Let's just find that Lord. This place is weird. Let's just find that Lord Farquaad guy and get out of here.
Ooh, I want to stop at the gift shop and get a t-shirt.
We're not stopping for t-shirts.
Such a perfect town. Here we have some rules, let us lay them down. Don't make waves, stay alive, now we'll get along fine. Do like it's a perfect place. Please keep off from the grass, and your shoes wipe your face. Do like it's a perfect place.
Infested freaks on every corner. I had them all arrested. Hey, naughty, 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 no. If you had a quirk, you didn't pass inspection. We all have our standards, but I will have perfection. And so. Looking up here in Duloc.
They're looking up.
The things I'm cooking up here in Duloc.
He likes to cook.
A model that faces a man with seven faces.
Bum, 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 bum.
Things are looking up here in Duloc. To my new dress code, the fashion's never washing. Hey, naughty, naughty, naughty.
Johnny know. This castle I had built is taller than the cliff tops. A city like a postcard, a monorail and gift shops. And so, and so, and so, no one from the gutter in Duloc embrace the cookie cutter in Duloc. The upshot is enormous when you can chat.
Conform us.
Yes! Things are looking up
here in Duloc.
Hey, let's hear for those Duloc dancers. Aren't they just terrific? Flamingo and jazz. My hard work and my vigor have made me so much bigger. Things are looking up.
Things are looking up.
Things are looking up here in Duloc.
Have the honor of rescuing the Princess Fiona from the fiery keeps of a dragon. Spin that barrel.
Excuse me. Roar. Are you a little Farquaad?
Maybe. Does the name strike fear in your heart?
No, but a little hat does.
Oh, who let this thing in here?
I'll be out of your silky hair shoes. You give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yes, where you dumped all those little fairy tale creatures.
Newsflash, ogre. That oozing mud pit is actually within the province of Duloc, and therefore under my jurisdiction.
Now listen here, half pint.
Wait. Wait a minute. Oh, this is too perfect.
What is?
You! You're big and hulking and wonderfully expendable. People of Duloc, we have a winner! Stop it. Congratulations, Ogre. You've won the honor of embarking on a great and noble quest.
But we're already on a quest.
Yeah, to get my swamp back.
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. All you have to do is one more simple little task, and I'll hand over the deed to your swamp.
Now, what exactly is this little task?
Oh, Walter! The dossier on Her Royal Highness.
Things are looking up here in Duloc. Here
was odd. Right?
Yeah, it was kind of odd.
But what's more odd is you agreeing to go on this quest. What do you know about rescuing a princess anyway?
I've read the stories.
And I've read the sports pages. I am not a star hockey player.
Oh, come on, donkey. Dragon, tower, power could it be?
I bet we're about to find out. What's this hand on the princess anyway?
She supposedly likes long walks on the beach, lazy Sundays, and Tex-Mex.
Ooh, she sounds nice. What else?
She was locked in a tower ever since she was 7 years old.
Oh, that's so sad. All alone? Since she was 7 years old? 7 years old? 7 years old.
You're so weird.
Just like me, poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing like someone else I know. As years go by, she sits and waits as years go by. A torturous existence. I don't remember this part. She wishes she were dead. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, Rapunzel finds a millionaire. The prince is good at climbing and braiding golden hair. So I know he'll appear, cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight, my white knight, and esteem will look just like these pictures. It won't be long now, I guarantee. Day number 23. I know it's today. I know it's today.
Here's a good one. It's a classic. In a coma, glad it's her instead of me. Pretty maiden in a glass box, how I wonder does she pee? Blah, 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 poison apple, boring, boring, evil queen. Filler, filler, bend the rut, that's seven shorties on the scene. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, the princess wakes up with a start. The prince is good at kissing and melting Snow White's heart. So I know he'll appear here, and his armor will be blinding, as perfect as his shining teeth and manly hose. He'll propose on my knee, and our prenup will be binding. About time we set a wedding day. Day number
958. I know it's today. He'll show up today. There's a princess, any princess. Take your pick, they're all like me. Not exactly, I'm still waiting. They're out living happily. Ever after, better get here. I want love in seconds flat. No one needs these middle bits. Whoops, did I do that? Cut the villains, cut the vamping. Cut this fairy tale. Cut the peril and the pitfalls. Cut the puppet and the whale. Cut the monsters, cut the curses. Keep the intro, cut the verses. And the waiting, the waiting, the waiting. won't mind. I'm a find, I'm a catch, and a very gifted bowler. It won't be long now, I guarantee. Day number. Are you there, God? It's me, Fiona. It's me, Fiona.
Shrek, this one I'm not getting. Shrek, this one I'm not getting. Why don't you just make Farquaad give you back your swamp? You know, pull some of that ogre stuff on him, you know? Lay siege to his forces, throttle him, the whole ogre trip.
Well, for your information, ogres are more than what people might think.
Oh, really? Okay. What's an example, please?
Example. Onions.
They stink.
Yes. No!
They make you cry.
No!
Oh, you leave them out in the sun too long, they start turning brown and sprouting little white hairs.
What? No! Layers. Ogres have layers. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Don't you get it? We both have layers.
Oh, you both have layers. Okay. You know, no one really likes onions, though. Ooh, parfaits. Everyone likes parfaits, and they have layers. Have you said to a person, hey, let's go get some parfaits, and they say, hell no, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are nothing like parfaits.
Parfaits may be the most delicious thing on the whole damn planet.
You know, this may turn into the longest day of my entire life.
Ooh, I got the perfect remedy for that.
What? No, donkey, please, I'm begging you.
Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you gotta go somewhere. Cause the fun is getting big. Yeah! What the heck, I must confess, I love a road trip. Sing a song, hit the trails, forget the maps, forget the guides. Before you know it, you gain ground with me. And I know all I need all along is a path and a pal and a song. So I'm singing and I'm palling with you. See, we can go by so much faster.
Why me? Why me?
This is nice.
Tell me what was my crime.
We are strolling.
As tiny as a parrot's more annoying than a mime.
Hey look, a cat's wearing boots, that's crazy.
Why me? Why me? A simple answer would be fine. Won't someone please send me a sign?
God, this is good cardio.
Did I do to deserve this honestly? This ass of mine is asinine. Why me?
Oh, look, a little bunny.
Oh, he looks delicious. What's so funny?
Oh, I just got that he must be compensating for something joke. I finally get it.
Moo.
Run, run. Are they still after us? Oh, jeez.
The Lila in the jungle, there's a green man and a donkey.
Why me?
Sing a song,
why me?
The trail.
A
know it. Please send me a sign. What did I do to deserve this honestly? This ass of mine.
In a palace.
This ass of mine. With you.
Jeez, you feel that breeze?
Aye.
It came up so suddenly.
That's because we're on a bridge to the Dragon's Keep.
Oh. We're on a bridge. Wait. You're telling me this is the bridge to the Dragon's Keep?
Yeah, why?
So that intense heat I feel kind of under my clothes wouldn't happen to be you.
That would be the pit of molten lava.
Oh. The pit of molten lava!
Donkey!
We're on a rickety bridge over a lake of molten lava!
Just calm down. Whatever you do, don't look down.
I'm looking down, Drek! I'm looking down!
Oh, for the love of Pete!
I'm falling to a chair!
Just take a step!
I can't!
Take my hand!
I can't!
Now take a step!
Okay, but don't let me go. Don't let me go.
I won't let you go. I won't let you all go.
What? Did I do to deserve you, my pal, evermore? We crossed the bridge together. What a beautiful metaphor. So now I'm singing, and I'm palling, and I'm dancing with you.
That'll do, Donkey. That'll do.
Trek, was that you? You gotta warn someone before you crack one off. My mouth is open and everything.
Donkey, believe, trust me. If it was me, you'd be dead. It's brimstone.
Right, brimstone. Don't be talking about it's the brimstone. I know what I smell. It ain't no stone. It certainly don't come from brimstone.
Oh, look. This might come in handy. Okay. You stay here while I go rescue the princess.
Wait here? By myself? Alone?
Unless you were to come want to slay the dragon and rescue the princess.
No. Have fun with that. I'll stay here and we wait. Wait, fine. But it'd be nice if you hurry back. Oh, jeez, this place is creepy.
You know for heaven? Sorry.
Oh, no. Shrek, help! There are people here with beards!
Shh. You don't want to wake her up.
Who are you people? What are you talking about?
We're knights. We came to rescue a princess.
Just say cute. None of us made it, though.
None of us made it, though.
She kisses around because we saved Becca.
What? I'm out of here!
That's what we thought.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
That's what we did.
Dragon!
That's what we said.
Another day inside my gear. I get no rest, I get no sleep. Cause when I start to count my sheep, you come around.
Oh, I can come back later then, okay, bye.
I draw my shades and lock my doors. Still you come for what ain't yours. Like a hound dog on a floor. We sniff around and around and around.
Another night.
Can't see that? You got your eyes checked. Technically, that princess ain't even my type. Do you want to know why? Okay, it's because
I like a big, big girl. I like a big, big girl.
Bow for me, boys.
He likes a big, big girl. He likes a big, big girl.
And as for you, I think you're bluffing. Stomping around, all huffing and puffing. You want true love? Stop with the hate. Unchain your heart, he's out there waiting.
He's a big, big girl. He likes a big, big girl.
I've been on something very valuable today. Now, excuse me. I'll be on my way. What's wrong? You got something in your eye?
No princess, but he wants me. No great beauty, but he wants me.
What?
No one ever, ever, ever wants me.
Ooh, I know it's a day. Ooh, I know it's a day. Ooh.
Hello? Anyone up there? Should you toss down some hair or something? Jesus. Oh. I knew I should have worn my cup. Oh, great. Got me a snoozer. Oh. Wake up! Are you Princess Fiona?
Yes. I am.
awaiting a
knight nice.
As bold as to rescue me.
That's nice.
But wait, Sir Knight. I would like to know the name of my rescuer.
Shrek.
Sir Shrek, I pray you take this favor as a token of my gratitude.
Thanks. Now, where's the door?
There is no door.
What? How do we escape?
By the same way you came up.
The same way I got. Oh, come on. Just. All right. Come on. Hop on.
But wait, Sir Knight. It beeth our first meeting. Wouldn't you like to savor the moment? It must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
Ah.
Climbing in to rescue me, this was always meant to be. This is how the scene must go. You're standing there, the light just so. Then you smile and gaze at me. Take my hand on bended knee. Bended knee. Bended knee. Ah. Sorry. And though we've only met, somehow I always knew it would look like this when dreams come true.
Shrek!
Hey, where are you going?
I gotta save my ass.
Breaks your nice so down a bit. Shutting girls are delicate. I've longed for this my whole life long. Now you're doing it all wrong. Down a rope a steed awaits, just as every story states. Riding over rough terrain, past the dragon you have slain. You have slain. You have slain.
It's on my to-do list.
Hey, get away! All under physical contact! No!
Drag! Dragon!
You're the knight, fight it!
Just relax and take a breath. Hope he doesn't burn to death. Never mind the protocol. He's your hero after all. Ta-la-la-la was past his past. Ta-la-la-la, I'm free at last. Cause in the end, the princess, she'll always get her man. And underneath that helmet, I bet he has a tan. My champion, my savior, my dashing Romeo. He has a talking donkey. That part I didn't know. Wait a minute.
I can feel my back is open.
In the book, it's just like in the book. Fighting over me as it was meant to be. As if you thought, play the dragon and goodbye. Oh my god, we're gonna die!
Here you go, Shrek. Have fun. Play the dragon, Shrek.
Just go. Go. Just get out of here.
You're good, man. You're good.
This is how I pictured it. More or less, I must admit, a thumping in my heart. A life about to start. I knew this day would come, and you would find your way. I know I always knew. I knew that it would be unorthodox, I'll admit, but thy deed is great, and thine heart is pure. I am eternally in your debt. Of course. And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
Well, you heard that. She called me noble steed. She thinks I'm a steed.
Well,
Sir Shrek, the battle is won. You may remove your helmet.
Uh-oh.
No.
Why not?
I have helmet hair.
Mm-hmm. Please, I would just like to look upon the face of my rescuer.
No, you wouldn't just.
But how will you kiss me?
What? That wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a perk?
No, no, it's destiny. A princess is rescued by a brave knight. Then they share true love's first kiss.
That's on you, not me. But wait, 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 but wait. You're telling me you think Shrek is your true love?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now remove the helmet.
Let's just say I'm not your type.
Not even a little.
Of course you are. Now take it off.
No.
No, take it off.
I wouldn't.
Take it off now!
All right. As you command, Your Highness.
Have fun burning.
You're an ogre?
Oh, were you expecting Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually. Oh, I was supposed to be rescued by my true love, not some ogre and his pet.
From steed to pet? Damn. That's hurtful and so much like noble steed.
Look, Princess, I was sent here by Lord Farquaad. He's the one who wants to marry you.
Well, then yeah. Why didn't he come rescue me?
That's a good question. You'll ask him that when we get there tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset. We need to make camp.
What? But we just escaped.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to rest immediately.
All right, this...
I need to rest now.
All right. All right. Easy. Go. There's a cave over there. Should find something.
What? Shrek, that's a list for a princess.
No, it's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
Oh, want me to read your bedtime story?
I said good night.
She's nice. I like her. We just escaped the Dragon's Keep. I realized if we did that, we really could do anything. Maybe I could be a noble steed. Or I could work the Crusade Circus if I wanted to. Oh, hey, I could even one of those horses that pull a wagon full of beer. I need hair extensions on my ankles, but I can do it. Who do you want to be?
No one.
But if you had to?
Donkey.
Like, if a guy had a sword of your throat saying like this, like, look here, ogre, you can't be an ogre anymore. Pick something else. Then who would you pick?
I would pick that guy up and hurl him into a tree.
Man, you are no fun. Is this what I'm going to be like when we're at our swamp all day? Just sitting around doing nothing for the rest of our lives?
We? Donkey, there is no we. There is no our. There's only me and my swamp. And when I do get back, the first thing I'm going to do is build a 10-foot wall around my land.
You cut me deep, Shrek. You cut me real deep. What's your problem against the whole world? What did it do to you anyway?
I'm not the one with the problem. It's the world who has a problem. You've seen how that princess reacted. It's how it is all the time. See, they're, run, a big, stupid, ugly ogre. They judge me before they even know me. That's why I'm better off alone.
Well, you know, Shrek, when we first met, I didn't think you was a big, stupid, ugly ogre.
Yeah, I know.
So there's no one else you'd rather be?
I guess I'd be a hero with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. Or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring. Upon a Viking ship, I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches. I feel the wind, I taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story. One that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. And to the skies I throw it. The stars would do the telling. The moon to help with spelling. And night would dot the eyes. I write a verse, recite a joke, and wit and perfect timing. I share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all rhyming. But we all learned, but we all learned. An ogre always hides, an ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. Yes, I'd be a hero, and if I wish for granted, life would be enchanted. What's all the stories say? Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast. I'd somehow overwhelm it. I get the girl, I take a breath, and I remove my helmet. We stand and stare, speak of love, we feel the stars ascending. We share a kiss, I find my destiny. I'd have a hero's ending, a perfect happy ending. That's how it would be, a big, bright, beautiful world, but not for me. An ogre always stays in the dark.
You're all alone.
All alone. I know he'll be here.
And if I wish for granted, life will be a challenge. What so the soul will say?
I will use the story.
And I will scale the tower to save my heart of flowers.
That they've ever done, ever.
I guess after Lion King being our first and Beauty and the Beast being our second, we just couldn't get enough. Isn't that right, Luke?
Yeah. Who thought that was a good idea?
I don't know, but I thank them because it gave us a chance to give the school amazing characters, such as you as Farquaad, correct?
Oh, yeah. I do play Lord Farquaad in the play.
How is that?
Pretty hard.
I've heard that you have to wear knee pads.
Oh, yes. Yes, I do. How is it being Princess Fiona?
Fiona's a wonderful character, and I find that that as a contrast to me playing Belle last year, I'm able to explore new parts of theater that I haven't before. Playing a funny character is actually pretty interesting. You get to see parts of yourself you haven't seen yet. I hope that the people who come to Woodward enjoy it, don't you?
Yeah, I sure do.
I know that a lot of people have been putting their blood, sweat, and tears into making the costumes, the makeup, the props, such as Mr. Tobin. I wonder what he has to say about it.
I sure do wonder, too.
Hello, everyone. This is WCN News. I'm your host, Kevin Mushani, and today I'm going to interview Mr. Tobin.
Hi, good morning.
Mr. Tobin, how are preparations going for the Shrek musical?
Oh, they're going very well. We've made several parts, or several sets so far for the play. This is one of them. This is going to be the shack where Fiona does her transformation.
Thanks. What role did you play in the creation of the musical?
Well, we built all the flats, they call them flats, or sets for the musical. And my woodshop class in period 6 did a lot of the work. We helped put everything together, so.
That's great to hear.
Isn't that lovely? I know that besides the teachers, the students have been putting a lot of work into this play as well, especially the cast members, don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We've worked really hard, and I know that you've been talking about a promo video you were working on, correct?
Oh yeah, that's right. I, Luke, the man, the myth, the legend, have made a promotion video for Shrek the Musical. It'll be playing in like a couple of seconds, but I just want to tell you, it's really truthful. All of the critiques from WCN News and all of that were totally not made up at all.
Don't you love that shameless self-promotion?
Yep.
We asked a bunch of people to name a word that comes to mind when you think of...
What are you doing in my swamp?
What word comes to mind when you think of the word Shrek?
Onion.
Green.
Ogre?
Comedy.
I think of swinging him around like a sack of potatoes, and then I...
So, what's the first word that comes to your mind when you think of Shrek?
Ogre.
So, Shrek the Musical's coming. How does that make you feel?
Vulgar.
Get out of here!
What word comes to mind when you think of Shrek?
Green.
Green.
Green!
Why are you asking me this?
I'm glad you asked that question, because 3 nights in June, Woodward & Co. is hosting Shrek the Musical, featuring amazing world-stopping performances from our students. They've worked very hard to present us with this magical night. Come, bring the whole family. You might even find a surprise when you show up. Be there or be square.
Shrek the Musical is a very good musical. Man, I don't think anyone appreciates how hard it is to talk like this. Oh, jeez, I just went off script. Ah, shoot, I did it again. Oh, crud, I did it again. Man, I should just give up.
Oh my god, wasn't that promo video just so amazing? I put my life's work into that. My blood, sweat, tears, other bodily fluid.
They can see that. Come on. They want to watch the musical. Let's skip now to Act 2.
Shimmering love, we'll be
Good morning, birds. Good morning, trees. Oh, what a lovely day. The sun's so big, it hurts my eyes. But really, that's okay. A brand new day with things to do. So many plans to make. I've had 6 cups of coffee, so I'm really wide awake. I've always been a morning person, a morning girl. Hooray!
Cheep, 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 cheep.
Hooray!
Cheep, 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 cheep.
Haven't met my husband yet, but I'm hopeful anyway. I'll wear a gown, we'll have a ball, and dance forevermore. He'll take me in his massive arms and spin me around the floor. I've always been a morning person, a morning girl.
What's so good about it? I can't get this stupid rat to follow me.
Well, I think you need to change your tune, mister.
Thank you.
safe.
Why, good morning, Ben.
Morning.
Morning, Princess.
Princess, do you often frolic with rats?
No, I'm just happy that it's a new day, full of promise and fresh starts. First thing I'd like to do is apologize for my behavior yesterday. We obviously got off on the wrong foot. So, I gathered berries for the trip, and I made you each a daisy chain.
Aw, they're beautiful, Princess.
Well, too excited.
Aren't they beautiful, Shrek?
You'll grow to love them. Anyways, lead the way, gentlemen.
Princess, back to my question. Do you always frolic with rats?
No.
Why? I don't know. Princess, German-infested rodents. Not exactly what I expected.
Well, maybe you shouldn't judge people before you get to know them. Anyways, my groom-to-be, Lord Farquaad, what's he like?
Well, put it this way, Princess. Men of Farquaad's stature are in short supply.
Really?
Yes, but I should mention he's a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
And he's very good at small talk.
Hey, what are you guys doing?
Nothing.
I'm just saying you might want to lower your expectations a bit.
like maybe 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. Not today. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
Right. Lifetime of misery. Right.
You chuckled. When I said lifetime of misery, you chuckled.
I did?
Yeah, you did.
Oh. Well.
All right then.
But, wait. But, I was just saying that it could be nice to have a bed, tower, better than what I had growing up.
You're not actually comparing yourself to what I endured, right?
What? I shampoo a couple times.
I mean, about my life.
What, that cushy tower of yours?
There's the things you don't know about me, you know, about how rough I had it.
Again, in that cushy tower of yours.
Cushy, are you kidding? I had nothing in that tower. Fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles. I had only bare essentials, army cot, a hot plate, and a chamber pot. And every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet. Just a view of devastation out one window, isolation in my bedroom, and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited. I'm very dedicated. On the walls the days were added. Luckily those walls were padded. So I think I got you. I think I got you, yeah. I think I got you, I think I got you,
you think so? That was a sad story, but I heard better. I'm just saying, A for effort, thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had it rougher. Like that time when mob with torches burned my bridges. See the scorches, you're just whiny. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder. Would an older go to heaven? Did I mention I was 7? So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
No warm regards.
No Christmas cards.
Better out than in, I always say.
Yonder window breaks. It is Fiona, and Farquaad is the sun.
My lord, we've just got a word that Princess Fiona is on her way.
On her way? Rah! She's on her way, and so am I. My fairy tale princess, I always knew this day would come, and now look, the last adorable piece to my master plan. Ooh, that reminds me. How are the wedding preparations coming?
We booked the cathedral at the band.
I did wonder if you wanted to maybe find your father.
My who?
Your father, my lord.
Do you mean that horrible little man that tried to keep me down my whole life? That mal-tempered monster? That vile grunt who abandoned me alone in the woods as a child?
Well, he did have his reasons.
Like it please, my father simply couldn't handle I wanted nothing to do with that family business. That lowly, dirty, family business. My daddy was a miner, so he wasn't much around. Foraging for diamonds, a life spent underground. Daddy didn't talk much, he barely said hello. He simply muttered, hi-ho. And off to work he'd go. Daddy was grumpy. My mama was a princess who left her crown behind. Daddy was a true love, so mama didn't mind. I never knew my mama, but she could.
from me.
Seven to a bed.
Ooh, you abandoned me alone in the woods, Daddy. Oh, but I crawled right out and up. Oh, you can just see me now, Daddy. I'd invite you to the west, but you don't see it.
La 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 la.
Packs of royal lackeys playing violin. Who will let us win?
Gonna pay, Daddy. It's any day, Daddy. I want to work.
We're here.
What is it?
It's Duloc.
Oh. Duloc, I didn't realize you were so close.
Neither did I.
Congratulations, Princess. Your future awaits.
Yes, it does.
So much for the little batch of Snuthers I was going to make us.
Snuthers?
Oh, they're like your traditional ogre campfire snacks. Similar to s'mores, but without the chocolate or marshmallow, oh, geez. It's like, oh, just squirrel gizzards and malt, oh, they just melt in your mouth.
Oh, I think I'm gonna be sick. I gotta sit down for a sec.
No, no, no sitting down. We have to get the princess to Duloc.
No, Shrek, I won't get another chance to try one of those Snuthers.
You eat one, you may not get another chance to try anything.
Zip it, donkey.
Okay. I was just thinking maybe Duloc could wait till tomorrow morning.
Morning?
Yeah, I mean, spent my whole life without my true love. What's one more night?
All right. I'll get us some dinner.
Okay, I'll get the,
all right.
The firewood.
Do you want to go that? No, wait, you go that way. No. Want to go together?
Yeah.
something going on around here. I've been watching and the signals are clear. A nervous laugh when she brushes his skin. The sweaty palms, the big dopey grin. With a giggle and a flip of a hair, I smell the pheromones in the air. Making Google eyes over their food, they need my help here in setting the mood. Oh, you don't believe love is blind? Well, I got some friends who might think otherwise. And here they are, direct from my imagination. Oh. Watch your step, girls. You gotta turn up the heat, you gotta butter the pan, you gotta make a move and don't be afraid. Reach for a hand, maybe give her a kiss, she's waiting for a move to be made. You gotta, 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 yeah, you gotta make a move. Make a move. Yeah!
These snuggers are so good.
They're nutty, right?
Mm-hmm.
Delicious. Whoa. Delicious.
Yeah. I guess I'll be dining all differently tomorrow night.
Oh my god, you see.
Well, maybe if you want to come down to my swamp sometime, I'll cook you all sorts of stuff. Like swamp toad soup, fish eye tartare, you name it.
I'd love that.
Shrek, I know you can't hear me right now, but if you're good, I'd like to say a few things to you. I think you're a corner, buddy. You got to tell this girl what you really feel deep down. You may not get another chance. So just go on now. Open up your heart. Just tell her how you really feel it. You can do it, buddy.
Princess.
Always gonna do it?
Yes, Shrek?
I was wondering.
Oh, I can't wait.
I was wondering.
Out.
Are you gonna eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you? You gotta make a move. You gotta shift in the gear. You gotta buckle down and give it a whirl. The scene is set right out of a book with a sunset and a beautiful girl. So you gotta, gotta, gotta. You gotta make a move. Come on, baby. You gotta make a move now, baby. You gotta make a move now, baby. Yeah, 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 yeah. Make a move. Yada! That was fun. Let's do it again. Gotta come on, make a move now, baby. You gotta make a move, come on, baby.
Okay.
You gotta make a move now, baby.
Okay.
Make a move, yeah, yeah, baby, yeah.
Donkey!
Oh, sorry. I got caught up in the magic of the night. The fireflies, that beautiful sunset.
Sunset? Oh my gosh, it's sunset. I gotta go inside.
All right. Good night.
Good night.
No. No, siree, no. I did not come all this way putting up with you and your body odor to let this girl walk away.
What are you talking about?
I'm an animal, if you haven't noticed. So I got instincts, and I can tell you and this girl are digging each other.
You're crazy.
So you don't have feelings for her?
Not saying that I do, but if I did, which I don't, she's a princess, and I'm...
An ogre?
Yeah, an ogre.
She needs to know.
Where are you going?
To get more wood before your fire dies. You can thank me later. Princess? Okay, I can do this, donkey. Princess? Princess, where are you? It's spooky, and I don't like spooky. Okay, can you tell me what's going on?
Ah! No!
Help!
It's
Shrek!
Okay!
Oh, jeez.
It's me.
Who are you?
princess.
Donkey, I am the princess. It's me in this body.
Oh my God, you ate the princess? Don't worry, princess. I'll get you out of there.
Donkey!
Keep breathing.
Donkey.
Princess? Is that you? What happened?
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss and then take love's true form.
That was beautiful, princess. I didn't know you write poetry.
It's a curse. I've had it since I was a girl.
A curse?
A witch casts a spell on me somehow every night when the sun goes down, become this horrible, ugly beast.
Now calm down, you ain't that ugly. Now I ain't gonna lie, you are that ugly. But strikes ugly 24/7. Wait a minute, wait. This is perfect.
Perfect? Donkey, if Lord Farquaad finds out I look like this, he'll never marry me.
So?
So I have to kiss my true love. The kiss is the only thing that will break the spell and make me beautiful.
But, you know, you're kind of an ogre, and Shrek, well, you two got a lot in common.
Shrek?
Yeah, I figured if he knew about this,
No, he can't know, and you can't tell him, not a word. No one must ever know. Promise me you won't tell, promise.
All right, I won't tell him, but you should. Man, when this is over, I'm gonna need a whole lot of serious therapy.
Princess, how's it going, first of all?
Good?
Good for me, too. I'm okay. I picked this flower right over there is where it grew. And I don't really like it, but it made me think of you because it's pretty. Is what I'm trying to say, that you are all so pretty, but I like you anyway. So please accept this flower with its petals and its stem, which represents my feelings and tells you how. Oh man, I'm in trouble. When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail too? Hello, fair princess. Oh, look, the moon is out tonight. You remind me of that moon because it's big and bright. And by big, I don't mean chubby. Obviously, you're not fat, but your personality is biggish, is what I meant by that. Sorry about that fat thing, I'm on the healthy side myself. I have to blame the gene pool, which reminds me of... Oh man, where am I going with this? When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, she'll just take my hand. She sees me like no one else has. When words fail, she'll understand. In the mud, oh, fail, she'll know what I mean. When words fail, she'll just take my hand. She sees me like no one else has. When words fail, she'll understand. She'll understand.
I can't think about Shrek. Not now. I'm a princess after all, and look at me, I mean really.
Who could ever love a beast so hideous and ugly? Princess and ugly don't go together. That's why I can't stay here with Shrek. My only chance to live happily ever after is to marry my one true love.
I've had a long and restless night pondering true love. My fairy tale I know so well has somehow gone awry. Looks can be deceiving, but feelings cannot lie. Do I love him? Last night I was uncertain, but this morning, this morning, this morning. Shrek, thank goodness there's something I have to tell you.
Nope, you don't have to tell me anything. I heard enough of it last night.
You heard what I said?
Every word. Especially who could love such a hideous, ugly beast.
But I thought that wouldn't matter to you.
Yeah, well, you know what, princess? It does. Ah, just in time. Princess, I got you a little something.
Fiona!
Princess Fiona?
As promised. Now about my swamp.
Clear it off as agreed, and the deed has been put in your name. Oh, that reminds me. Let me just get this out. Oh. Here you go. Forgive me, Princess, for startling you. I am Lord Farquaad.
Lord Farquaad. Forgive me. Lord Farquaad, forgive me. For I was meaning just to say a short farewell.
Oh, that's so sweet. But you don't have to waste manners on the ogre. It's not like it has feelings.
No, you're right, it doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona, I ask your hand in marriage. Will you be the perfect bride for the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad, I accept. Nothing would make me...
Excellent! I'll start the plans for tomorrow we wed.
No. Let's get married tonight, before sunset.
Oh, anxious are we? Captain, right ahead. Tell them it's a code red. You're right, the sooner the better. We'll be married by sunset.
Oh, man. There is nothing that a bit better than a good night's sleep. Am I right, Shrek? Wait, what did I just miss?
Fare thee well. Fare thee well, ogre!
Shrek, what are you doing? You're letting get away. Look, there's something you don't know. I talked to her last night, and...
Yeah, I know you two talked to each other last night. You guys are such good pals. Then why are you going to follow her home?
But Shrek, I want to go home with you.
I told you already. There is no we. There is no our. There is only me. My swamp, understand? Nobody, especially useless, pathetic, annoying, talking donkeys!
But Shrek, I thought we were...
But you know what? You thought wrong. I'm gonna build me a wall. I'll make it 10 feet high. See you later, pal. Bye-bye. Can't you take a hint Am I getting through it all? Just get out of here. I was told the world would despise me, so I should have known. I should have guessed. I thought these two might be different. Well, now I know they're just like all the rest. I'm gonna be what they want, 'cause Ogre has to do what he has to do. I thought these two might be different. Well, now I know they're just like all the rest. I'm gonna be what they want. I'm gonna be what they say. Hey, world, I'll do it your way. You're looking for a monster. It's your lucky day. I'll be what you want. I open my heart and let her walk through. She wanted Prince Charming. I wanted my home back. How lucky, but how wishes came true. Gonna build me a wall, a perfect place to hide. The best way to conquer, they say, is to defy. Gonna build a wall, gonna be what they say, gonna hide in my heart. Gonna build a wall.
Miles north, they said there's a landfill with our names on it.
Landfill? Are you kidding me? What's next? Downhill? A septic tank? How low do we need to go, people? It's time we stood up to Farquaad ourselves!
Stand up for ourselves! Stiffing the Pam?
Gingy's right. We need to get off our butts and do something.
Maybe we should beat the landfill.
Now, wait a minute. Maybe that ogre wasn't the answer. But something better will come along. We have to wait for it, because that's what frail creatures do. We wait for miracles, we wish upon stars. What did Cricket always told me?
Forget that old Cricket. He was so smart, he was seeing that wind shot coming from my own way.
No. We just need to lay low until this all blows over. None of this would have happened if I was a real boy. Why can't I be a real boy right now?
Listen up, puppet.
We spent our whole lives wishing we weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way, but it's they who need to change. It's time to stop the hiding. It's time to stand up tall. Say, hey, world, I'm different. And here I am, splinters and all. Splinters and all.
Yeah,
let your freak flag land.
My what?
Let your freak
doing?
Oh, I thought you of all people could recognize a wall when you see one.
What? Yeah, but the wall's supposed to go around my land, not through it.
And it is around your half. You see, that's your half. This is my half.
Your half.
Uh-huh, my half. I didn't have to work. I have rescued the princess, so I get half the booty.
Back off.
No, you back off.
Stubborn jackass.
Smelly ogre.
This is my swamp!
There you go again. My, my, my. Me, me, me. Look here. Now it's time you listen to me. So you just shut up and listen. You are mean to me. You either push me around or push me away. You were so wrapped up in later, Onion Boy, you faced your own feelings.
Well, if I treated you so badly, then why did you come back?
That's what friends do. They forgive each other.
Oh, back off.
There you go again. Doing it to everyone, just like you did to Fiona. And all she did was like you. Maybe even love you.
Love me? I heard the two of you talking last night. You know, about how I was such a hideous beast.
Well, do you want to know something? She was not quite you. She was talking about... Oh, yeah, right. Someone else.
So she wasn't talking about me? Then who is she talking about?
Uh-uh. No, no, sir, me, mister. You want to hear me talk? So I'm not talking.
Donkey.
No.
I'm sorry.
Not it.
I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry. You're right. Maybe I am just an ugly and stupid ogre. Can you ever forgive me?
Hey, what are friends for?
Friends?
Friends.
So, what did Fiona say about me?
Why are you asking me? Why don't you just go ask yourself?
Myself?
You did say you won your chance to be a hero. Well, this is your chance.
Donkey, the wedding! We'll never make it in time!
What kind of noble steed would I be if I ain't had a plan? Come on!
People of Duloc, we gather here today to bear witness to the union of our new king and queen. And as the warm glow of this setting sun sets and lifts our hearts, so too does the joy of this blessed...
Excuse me, can we just skip to the I do's, please?
Go on.
Very well. Do you, Lord Farquaad, take Princess Fiona?
I do.
And do you, Princess
Fiona? I do.
I was getting to that. So, by the power vested in me, I now pronounce you your new king and queen.
Stop the wedding!
Oh, really? What? It's rude enough being alive when nobody wants you, but showing up uninvited to a wedding?
Fiona, I need to talk to you.
Oh, now you want to talk. Well, it's a little too late for that, so if you'll excuse me...
But you can't marry him!
And why not?
Because he's only trying to marry you so he can be king!
What?! Oh, that is outrageous. Don't listen to him, Fiona.
Fiona, he is not your true love.
And what do you know about true love?
Aww. This is precious. The ogre has fallen in love with the princess. Oh, good lord. Guards, get this abomination out of my sight.
No, wait. I mean, let's hear what the monster has to say. Might be worth a laugh.
Oh, you're awful. You heard her, ogre. Express yourself with as few grunts as possible.
Okay.
Mm.
a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream, and if a dream comes true.
Awkward.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world. You know how that is. Blind, maybe you won't mind the view. I know I'm not the handsome prince from which you've waited, and I'm not handsome and I'm not sophisticated. A princess and an ogre, I admit, is complicated. You've never read a book like this, but fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. I'll see it now, I'll let it in. I'll tear down a wall and build a spot for two.
We demand our homes back.
And a rightful
place.
And a rightful place in Duloc, right, guys?
Yeah.
Let's get them.
How dare you freaks interrupt my wedding?
Freaks, eh? Well, I guess it takes one to know one. Be prepared to have your mind blown.
What?
Be prepared to have your mind blown.
Oh, Daddy!
It appears my invitation has been lost.
Well, maybe if you hadn't abandoned me in the woods.
Abandoned you? You're 20 and you live in my basement!
Ooh.
Oh. Yeah, some more. Nothing to say for that, dear son.
People of Duloc, your leader is a halfling!
Which is a lovely thing to be.
No! I'm not a freak! I'm a big man, a big, tall, giant man of the kingdom. I'm not, I have a castle.
Bring in the lantern.
Stop the wedding.
Fiona?
I wanted to show you before.
Well, that explains a lot.
Hocus pocus alters nothing. This marriage is binding. That makes me king. See? See? And as for you, my queen, I have you locked away in that dungeon for the rest of your days.
Actually, you won't.
What are you doing, you insolent beast? I'll have you drawn and quartered. I am king. I will have peace. I will have perfection. I will have order. I will have the
dragon!
Oh, I'm a dragon! I love you, baby!
So...
Yeah!
You were saying?
I'm your true love, Fiona.
Yes, and I'm yours.
Aww.
Aww. Finally.
Are you all right, Fiona?
Yeah, I'm all right. But I don't get it. I'm supposed to be beautiful.
You are beautiful. Once upon a time, to look like us would be a pity. But being beautiful ain't always pretty.
I've waited all my life, lived it by the book. Now I know that's not my story. Yes, I am. Love me, yes, I look. Standing here in all my glory, I am sweetness. I am pretty. I'm a princess. I'm a fatty. I'm a mess of contradictions in a dress. I am sassy. I am sappy. When I'm with you, I am.
My jokes, even though they're crude, and you know that I'm not classy. We only make a perfect pair, radiant and rude,
feeling over much too jazzy.
We are ogres, we are scary,
we are donkeys, we are hairy, we are bold and random stories to be. Oh, we will write them, we will tell them, you will hear them, you will smell them. This is our story.
And so, that's how a beautiful princess fell in love with an ogre on a swamp.
And he had his best friend by his side.
Yes, and his best friend.
That's a very handsome party!
We are heroes. We are shining on the stars to be shined. We
someone else, but not for me. Love was out to get me. That's the way it seemed. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. And then I saw her face.
I saw her face.
Now I'm a believer. I got, oh yeah,
oh yeah.
What's the use of trying? All you get is pain. When I wanted sunshine, I got rain.
I got rain.
Sorry I'm late. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace. Giant round of applause for this guy's last musical. Give a round of applause. A big round of applause. Let's hear it. Graduates, come up, come forward. Graduates, graduates, move forward. This is your last play, so you gotta move forward. Get the biggest round of applause. Graduates, up front. This is your last play. I feel like you should get the biggest applause. You are not a graduate, Farquaad. You dead. Okay.